So if you're in town.
Carolyn's at nine. Do you have anything for us?
I do.
Carolyn thinks she'd be here tonight. She has just come in today. She's hoping she'll be here tonight. That's why I put nine-ish.
So we have time for 30 minutes.
This is added in abates for, from the tax sale. I got all that done. Some of them I had to do a few added because there was overage. So you do an added tax to put it as a tax so it can be distributed then. So got all those done Monday, Friday.
All 17 of them or whatever it is?
Would you have a pre-run then?
Yeah, they're just like any other abatement. I just do those as a, it doesn't change value or anything, so it's just kind of like a tax override, so I do those.
We still have one that hasn't picked up the deed yet. Or we haven't filed the deed yet. Joe was supposed to send it.
Oh yeah, there's one more. Yeah, there'll be abatements on those then too.
This is.
Or no way, they paid. No, I think they paid. I have to look at that. I think they paid to the team at the United States.
To make a motion, we accept the tax roll corrections.
Second.
Motion second to accept the tax roll corrections. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Motion carried.
There you go.
What is this for? Seems very expensive for labor.
Pull the, let me pull the voucher. Are you done?
Well, I move that we approve the minutes of August 26th meeting. Second.
Motion second to approve the minutes of August 26th. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
That's
a couple pages long, huh?
Yeah. Lines. Better put that in order. You know what time it is.
I read the agenda as at 8:30 was today, not a week from today. No, it's not even.
What's that?
I read the agenda, the K word, yeah. As the end of day. I didn't see the September 16th.
Anything else? Anything else we're already set?
I attended a meeting last week. There's some concerned citizens about 281 and 50, and about 2 years ago you guys wrote a letter, and at the meeting they asked if I would visit with you guys about writing another letter to find out if they decided whether they're going to do anything. Or, and I think what brought it up again, those big turbines that they keep moving. Well, they get log jammed there at the intersection because they're too big, so not wide enough. And I agree with them, it's going to cause some problems. But, so I just told them I'd visit with you about it if you guys want to write it again. Because here's, I don't know if you guys remember it, but I didn't. And what they did send us, they, it was on the back page, they sent us a kind of a demographic deal of the accidents that occurred. It says where they stopped and failed to yield, but it doesn't really address what they're going to do. And I know at the meeting it was discussed, and I'm sure they're going to do it. They're going to get it. Petitions going around for the public to sign and support the letter that you send it. No. Trooper was there, but okay.
mean, I'm in favor of sending another letter, but I mean, we've done it in the past. We've got their answer. I don't know what it's going to take to get them off dead center. I mean, I'm already even considering.
I know Greg was going to try to get some contact.
Have you seen these letters and the responses?
Yes, I have copies of the letters we got.
Okay.
And the group, they talked about like doing a petition and getting some signatures, getting more of a group on board. Now, when they approached this, it was strictly approached from the accident, to tell the end of it. They thought maybe this time, from the point of view, we still have that, and add to the wind turbine problem.
Right.
And see, and I don't know, see, Great Bend qualified, I was going to ask Carolyn about this, but see, they qualified, they're down to two people for that transload shipping. But if they get that in, this is the southern corridor, so that would increase truck traffic as well, you would think, or have that potential. So there might be another armament to maybe get some movement here.
On the last Wednesday, I think it was, there was a wind turbine of blades coming from the east, and they went north.
Well, they...
But see, there's supposed to be this, what is it, 300 turbines in Pratt County?
Right. Well, they have to go north because they can't turn and go south. They have to come to St. John, turn around, and go.
Oh, really?
Yeah, it's not wide enough for them to make the turn. See, that stop sign on the south side has got all the hard wire with it.
Yeah.
So they can't take the sign down, and they can't make that corner.
Did they call for assistance from when they're making that turn?
No.
Okay,
no,
so they're out there with their own staff trying to shut down traffic. And
right, but we keep getting called to it because people call 911 because they're blocking the road. So
I have noticed that sometimes it depends on how they're hauling the turbine, the blades. Because some of the blades you see are angled up.
Well, and some of the newer ones
are just flat.
Yeah, some of the flat ones that are causing wider blade.
Wider blades, the flat, wider blade ones that are causing the problem because they can't clear the hardwire stop sign.
Of course, I know you worked one and I worked one. I think there were three this summer where someone was at the stop sign and a semi went to turn and they had to back up so the semi could make it and backed into somebody. Well, it's because the intersection's not wide enough to.
They have started pulling out the
signs
on one side of them, but it's still not
24 to 36 hours. I think they were waiting on the pilot car, the three yellow ones.
They were waiting to get a permit to go to Oklahoma.
Oh, really?
They can't get those permits, I heard, until they actually get here.
Is that right?
Yeah, they can't apply for them right now.
We're sketching the...
They're supposed to stay on the oversized load house.
Well,
pre-planned route.
That first time they couldn't make it, I was on the phone with KDOT three times, and thus they didn't want to go to St. John, they didn't want time because they're
off the
route. Yeah. So finally, KDOT gave me permission to send them to St. John and that way.
So. Yeah, the other day I combined this Nixon Street area and they had four or five of them piled in there.
That's just it, they're coming from all different directions. There was blades coming from the west, coming back east. And that's out of the ordinary.
I've had some stay in Stafford that are being routed from Newton, Iowa, and they say that they are being routed on Highway 50 and then to 281 south to, I forget what town in Oklahoma, but they stop here was what they were telling me at times because they have to have a police escort in Oklahoma, and if they can't get it scheduled until the next day, there's not very many options on places to stay. So Stafford is a reasonable stop for them.
I guess I'm curious to know who plans to route from Iowa. I mean, is it somebody in KDOT, or is it somebody
at the manufacturer?
Well, or somebody higher up than that. Well, it has to be approved by somebody. Mm-hmm. I mean, we've done that before, not on this scale, but I mean, your route's pre-planned for you.
Yes. It's not very direct.
Some of them say each state does it, and then it's sent off for national, and then they make sure it connects.
But I'm curious to know why they're sending them, if they know that intersection's not capable of holding that length of vehicle, why they're sending them that route, I guess. That's
yeah, they may not know that.
I mean, I don't.
Well, I would assume part of that is because they have a lot of those blades and everything stockpiled at Garden City. They also have some hut. So,
in New Iowa, apparently.
I guess I'm in favor of doing anything.
Well, we could draft another letter and send it off.
I mean, the guys before us and the guys before that have sent letters on that intersection, and we've done it
for years.
And it's just zero response. Not zero response, but zero
satisfaction.
Okay.
Thank you very much. Give us some ammunition to have some.
I guess we're going to be there.
There's a group of us who met with Jeff and Representative Lewis. What we would like to do, if it's possible, is in connection with sending the letter, have a public petition drive to include the signature with the letter of residents who are in support of another study. In view of now two issues, one is the safety of the intersection, and the other now is the loads that the intersection is being required to handle that it's really not able to. So if we could time the sending of the letter with an effort to get some public signatures to go along with it, that would be helpful.
I'd be happy to send a letter with it. Well, maybe we can get Senator Holmes to send a letter with it. The more we get on board, the more strength we'll have, I know.
Well, I would say also include people that are not locals, you know, but people who are using that.
Well, I mean, it's got to be an inconvenience for those companies that are trying to move the equipment.
I mean, rather than just the neighborhood, you know, circulating a petition in the neighborhood, rather, you know, expand it to, like Shane said, the transportation providers and whoever else is involved. Maybe Siemens or Hutch.
You what?
Maybe Siemens or Hutch. You know, whoever your supplier of the blades are.
Also, I haven't paid attention enough to know who the transport companies are.
There's several of them. They
so many different ones.
This is all over the country. They're doing either car business or escorts.
I'd be curious and see why the dispatchers is routing it on 50 rather than
61
or 54.
Yeah.
But that's not bad.
But I'm saying, you know, you've got, well, you still have the intersection of 281 and 54, and Pratt is probably more difficult than what 281 and 50 is. Mm-hmm. Because I followed one through Pratt one day. It was fine.
It also comes down to stop signs in towns that you have to go through to traverse. 50 has a lot less than 54 through this section.
Down 10th Street and Great Bend, you know, they go to 281 and 10th Street and Great Bend, and I mean, they'll have traffic blocked for 20, 30 minutes.
With the be.
Yeah, we'll do it. We'll do whatever we need to do.
Appreciate it?
Yep.
You got a copy there? I guess you would.
Send the copy of everything.
I'm.
We'll have a copy.
But somebody's done not going to get that.
Somebody's scheduled at 9:30.
Oh, I think Jeff got it, because they need to schedule that for you.
Oh, okay.
I think. That transfer got a great deal, and they can't take any more information. They've been pretty tough, too.
I mean, I got the press release.
That's all I've seen, yeah.
So I guess it's kind of, I don't know.
Let's see, see.
It characterizes Garden City or Great Bend, I mean, there's seven.
Well, I guess, I mean, they're starting to.
If they got finalized those two, and it looked like they had more places in order to sound like they had planned on running for two locations, well. If they got it down to two finals, they got two locations.
No, her petition is not.
Didn't take it, it was a done deal.
Yeah, I don't think it's a done deal either.
And that would be another, if that got in, that would be, you know, this is something cool.
Yeah, no, I already said that.
I'm gonna send them together.
She's gone through the work.
Yeah.
I read the state, United States, map of freight corridors is not rising to the top. That's part of our challenge. Highway 50 is not considered one of the priority freight corridors as compared to some of the other states. Yeah, exactly. 54 is considered a priority over 50.
Coming back, there was an RFP for improving health in rural counties. Commissioner Grimmon had brought to our attention, so we spent the last 2 weeks kind of talking with people around the county and trying to decide how to best craft this. We kind of started with the idea of what do you think is most needed? Tried to kind of take a broad and somewhat innovative approach. And one of the things that keeps rising up as kind of one of those challenges is the idea of drug enforcement. It's kind of, ongoing challenge there.
So education continues?
Staff, but it's kind of those things that we have challenges there. It leads into a lot of other things. So this RFP even acknowledged that law enforcement can be a part of building a healthy community, so we kind of started there. We have money for a few elements of law enforcement. One of them, we've talked with all of the local departments. We've had conversations with KBI and even the Attorney General on this, and kind of giving us some guidance on how drug enforcement task forces might be developed or whatever. A lot of times it boils down to more people can collect more evidence, and it doesn't allow for staff. And even if it did, $100,000 gets eaten up pretty fast and that kind of thing. So we didn't go that direction of trying to increase staff, but rather provide some equipment that the departments probably wouldn't otherwise have a budget to do, and kind of do some of that investigation for them. So poll cameras, actually just one, they're $13,000. But a poll camera and seeing the cost for installation so that it can be done kind of discreetly. Joey is a recording device, basically a hidden voice recording device. So some of these things might actually be more effective than eyewitness kind of things anyway, because of the fear cut when they collect evidence. Some of it might boil down to some community education on what kind of evidence people can provide that actually would hold up in court, trying to show probable cause if search warrants are needed, or in the course of doing the prosecution. Some things are more valuable than others, and if we can just teach people what to really look for if they want to assist, that might be useful. So we provided some money for that, and some of it's just kind of intelligence sharing. So we provided periodic just hosting lunches among the different departments so they can kind of get together and do some intelligence sharing. So that's one element of it. Followed that up with improved mental health, access to mental health services. We don't have anything in Stafford County, so that's probably in and of itself kind of an anomaly. There's, most counties would have some kind of mental health services, and we really don't. So working with Stafford County Hospital, they've been doing some telemedicine clinics, and we have the ability to do mental health counseling through that too. So that could include, what do you call it, substance abuse type counseling. Some of that's court mandated, and this would give a way to do that here. And some of it might be just through like referrals, schools, the health department, physicians, whatever. Some of it could be in that realm of substance abuse, but some of it, we are one of the top three counties, we're tied for first for tobacco use in the state. Adult tobacco use. So clearly that's one of those things that leads to a lot of unhealthy conditions. And so we might talk about that kind of substance too, as being something that can do tobacco cessation type of counseling, which can be one-on-one or group, but both of those things could be provided through this contractor that the hospital is looking for, and then are looking to partner with. And then even from the economic development side of things, you know, if we can expand the range of services and the revenue that goes to the hospital, that can, you know, have a local benefit as well. So we allowed money for getting that set up, some administrative costs that way. Probably a lot of the people that we're talking about will qualify for Medicaid, but we don't really know for sure if they either currently are signed up or if there will be glitches in trying to get them set up. At the same time, we can make the case that the service is needed, so we allowed for scholarships so that we're still, you know, we're not asking, you know, anyone locally to eat the cost of providing those services in this, during this project, but still can get it done. So mental health portion is best basically 25% of it. Law enforcement's basically 25%. Mental health, basically 25%. And then we saw a way to continue our housing work through this too, by doing kind of the same thing that we're doing in Hudson. We took a low-value house that was probably at risk of becoming one of those that's acquired by, it could be the location of bad behavior that we're trying to kind of address here too. We take one of those either tax delinquent or just low value houses that could be a problem, and we try to turn it around into something that is decent, affordable housing on the good side. So basically $25,000 a year for 2 years to do that. That work. That's basically what we're budgeting in Hudson. So that's the scope of the request here. We'll try to kind of present it that we're a progressive county that is taking this very holistic approach. In the cover letter here, I've made reference to the idea that the county and economic development already have this track record of working together, and kind of gave some information about the project we carried out together in Maxville. So we're not new to housing. We're not new to the idea of healthy community. It goes very much along with the idea of economic development too. Competing for some funding to create more walkable environments. We're kind of addressing that physical activity part. We've done high tunnels and doing some things related to nutrition. So we've kind of covered that part and making the case that this grant will just allow us to expand that scope of work. So. We have kind of an outline of the grant, a cover letter here. I don't need to read to you what it is, but they asked for the cover letter to be signed jointly by the county that is actually making the application. Essentially, the 501c3 is the physical agent. The way they described it, the money will actually be distributed to the 501c3.
You said 25% for law enforcement, 25% for mental health, 25% housing.
50%.
Which one's 50?
The housing's 50%.
Okay, all right. I was going to say I'm 25%.
It's 25,000 in each of 2 years.
All right.
The others are split. It's basically 25,000.
For law enforcement, you were talking about a camera?
A full camera, so it's basically put a hidden camera up in a place that they're suspecting activity.
So they could move it around though from place to place?
My understanding is that yes, once they're done with it in one place, they can take it down and put it somewhere else.
Let's say we've talked about putting cameras in the police officers or the sheriff's vehicles. But that probably would have much to do with drug enforcement part of it.
What they need to see is not just that traffic is coming and going or something that may add to a probable cause case, but they need to see some element of actual transaction.
Okay, I can give them some places to put a pole up. I see a lot of suspicious vehicles going in and out of the same location. So.
But that in and of itself, I think that's part of that community education piece. You know, just the traffic coming and going, I mean, it's a free country, people can come and go. You've got to have something more than that to really get the search, get the probable cause to stick so that you can get the search warrants and that kind of stuff. So.
But in the middle of a pasture.
So, you've got a place that a tree, a bull cam can be mounted.
Drive through and drive away sometime. How about a fishing pond?
So, the letter that's drafted in here is the cover letter. It's addressed to Mary Ann Burdenson at the Centene Foundation for Quality Healthcare. Dear Ms. Burdenson, please find and close the application from Stafford County, Kansas in response to the RFP improving health in rural counties. Our agencies are committed to ensuring the successful completion of this project. The County of Stafford and Stafford County Economic Development regularly work together for countywide improvement and have a track record of successful grant implementation together. One example is that the County of Stafford received a $168,000 housing grant that was used to construct new rental housing on land owned by Stafford County Economic Development. Stafford County Economic Development also contributed funding to this construction project and continues to manage the property now that construction is complete and is occupied. We believe this represents successful collaboration, and the result was the first new moderate income rental housing built in the town of Maxville, Kansas since 1948. We have received positive regional media coverage of this accomplishment, including articles in the Richmond Tribune and Hutchinson News. Stafford County is also part of the Healthy Communities Initiative through Kansas Health Foundation. Through this, three towns have developed master plans for improving sidewalks and bike lanes to make active living an easy choice and have a positive impact on public health. Because of planning work, the town of St. John was recently awarded a grant from the state of Kansas for over $200,000 to improve sidewalks. In 2012, a countywide project that supported healthy lifestyles and economic growth was the five new vegetable growing businesses were established through an initiative that provided the growers with high tunnels and training. These producers continue to grow produce and supply it to local outlets as well as a rejuvenated farmers market. Moreover, knowing that good jobs are the foundation of a vibrant economy and community, the County of Stafford has begun development of the Port Authority of Stafford County, which is an industrial use facility that offers unique benefits to port companies choosing to locate at the facility. We expect this to be a catalyst for business investment, job creation, and population growth. The work that is already going on in this county to achieve improvement is very closely aligned with the goals outlined in the RFP documents. We would welcome the opportunity to expand this work through the support of the Centene Foundation for Quality Healthcare. So. You're going to have all those timing.
One of the things just came to my mind in Stafford School. You know, I was doing that collaboration with the Hudson Tree Flower and also with their greenhouse from...
That's true. That's another one, though.
That's another filler, I guess. And at last I heard that there were hosts producing in the greenhouse and eventually one in the cafeteria.
Yeah. So,
along with the fish and what else. But. With it. So we need.
So it's all electronically submitted. Basically, we'll submit this document. And it just goes into and answers their list of questions, which are what is the problem and What problem issue would your project address? Describe the proposed project to address the problem outlined in question one. How will you know if you're successful? What will you measure? What are other community stakeholders, or what other community stakeholders have committed to participate? And attach a budget. That's what all of this is.
I make a motion we authorize the chairman to sign this letter of application in response to the RFP improvement held in rural counties.
Second.
Motion and second to authorize my signature on this application for the RFP improvement held in rural counties. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Motion carried.
Make some changes where we didn't have so damn many pumps, because with the spreader and then the snow plow each had an individual pump, and we got away from that, and we put a front drive pump like it's on a cement truck, and that's what we went to, and so that's what that additional part was for, plus mounting snow plow.
Well, there's two of them.
Yeah.
And the total bill is $10,341.
Yeah, the original. Okay, this was the original one that was approved, right?
$5,231
was the one that was approved. We approved that one, but not that one.
Okay.
I guess my question is, if we're just mounting pumps and doing hydraulic lines and things like that, why can't that be done in a county shop?
Well, there's a lot of fabricating because you had to extend the frame out on the front.
Okay.
And, I mean, there was a lot of hoses to run. It was a matter of time, I guess.
I mean, I just sent you $10,000
sure.
bill for labor.
No, that's no, that, I thought we had did this.
That's a lot of labor.
I thought we had did this, and we hadn't. And that's why I say this is on me, because I thought we had did this. So it's actually less than this, because we ended up getting a little bit of credit back from Southwest Truck, because we took the under the PTO pump off and on the transmission and did it and returned that back to them. So we got a little bit of credit there. We didn't have to buy a pump for the snow plow, so that's too long in between deals, I guess. Well, I will do it. I will try to do better. Give me a do better slip.
Well, you can just pay that bill.
That's easy.
Handle that.
So what do you want?
Well, that goes with those
that.
Two invoices.
Oh.
I need all that back.
I just was...
Oh, okay.
When I see the $10,000 bill for
sure.
labor, I...
No, I don't have it.
Okay, thanks.
Yeah, I thought we had approved, like
yeah,
I said...
Yeah, then I see on the description, it was just mounting the hydraulic pump and the hydraulic lines on it. We've got the shop.
Well, all them,
we just
yeah.
got our own
well,
shop.
All them lines come from the front, and you had to extend that frame, and that's where the snow plow mount was, and I don't know if that was on that one or on the first one.
first one was chopping the frame and installing the bed.
Okay, so this... Yeah, so it would have been for the hinge on the back of the truck, and that's where it controls, and that's the sewer plant's at. And the intake is quite time-consuming, really. I mean, we could have probably done it, but I don't know how long it would have took us because you've got so many people pulling it from the other direction. You know how that goes when things start going down.
Yep.
And it's hard to get anything done.
Not happening.
So, but he did a nice job. It just took a little while.
So actually, we saved $2,000.
A little bit.
$12,000. And his first bid was $13,000.
Yeah, on that part of it, we did. I mean.
Okey-dokey.
What does that mean? You got a live pump now, so
right.
That's all one pump. I've never heard of anybody that's ever really had any problems. Same thing as on the distributor. And then we should make them finish it. See you Friday. So tell the guys when they swing it in for the next while.
Be gentle.
Be gentle if they would, please.
I'll try.
That's all you can do is try. I mean, because sometimes you don't have much choice.
Yeah.
Are you going to put some posts up on the project over there by the co-op? Or?
I can't. I mean, I've looked at it, and they're not pushing the rock out, and it don't look like they're doing it on a consistent basis.
But they're getting awful close.
Yes, they are. we can do that. That's not it. I don't have a problem to
it. I think we should.
Okay.
Not those, though. Probably the white fiberglass ones that will move. You're not talking like a...
No, we'll put some green channel posts with delineators on them so they can see them.
I was thinking more of 6x6.
Because, well, I actually stopped in and talked to Paul, and he just shook his head. He said, you know how truck drivers are. Which is rather comical.
Yeah.
Deal with him.
Well, at least if you put a green post in there, you're going to know who hit it.
Yeah. We can do that.
I was just thinking something, if somebody did drive over, it would be a little more
friendly. Well, the trouble is, as soon as they find out that those,
they
will drive right over.
I don't think that you should stop for
them. Yeah, like, I mean, if you know something's going to kind of tear up something,
that's true.
Attention to it. Did get a pain in yesterday. Go ahead.
The drain by the bridge, is that new or was that existing?
That was existing.
And I didn't realize how much of a slope there was from the highway to that
There's
bridge.
A lot.
There is a huge drop.
The drop's pretty
good. As some of us have complained that when they were coming from the south, there was this dip after they crossed the bridge.
It's always been
that dip? Way. No, because you go from the, there's no fall off on the bridge.
After the bridge.
And then the word from the pipeline company?
Never heard of it.
Oh, how did it come out?
Of course.
Rubber stamp from favor of the pipeline company.
Really?
I can drive anywhere across this lane they want to.
Well, they aren't going to drive across that bridge before we start. I have a real problem with them trying to take anything with over that.
I got a problem with it, period.
Well, but you know that's IRA. The bridge thing we can control.
Right.
I mean, I do know what's in the semi-roads or stuff like that. Where you're coming out of semi-roads.
So legally, they just have access to go wherever they want.
That's what the judge said.
That didn't take very long either.
15 minutes.
Or is this up here?
Upstairs.
Who's
Keeley?
Is that a 15-ton limit bridge?
No.
Five.
That's what it's supposed to
be. Okay.
I just can't figure out.
At this time.
Is there a public road after? Or just
no,
to
I,
that,
I,
not
I,
just
I,
access to that house?
I think, if memory serves me right, the road ends at the end of the bridge. And then it becomes all private.
Okay.
Because it just kind of landlocked right. That from the so that way, we, you know, we had to do the bridge.
Right.
And that bridge had been there. We went in and redid it. All the time. I mean, it's got. I'm not missing.
I just don't like where that whole deal went down.
No, it puts us in our distance, but it's not.
I'm just glad we didn't approve the road crossing.
We'll see what they come back and say, but David, I firmly think there needs to be some stipulations about what they're going to take over in that bridge. Because the guy told me once, he said, well, we're just going to put a bridge out beside it.
Huh? You're talking to this egression deal, or Nick, they can do whatever they want to do on it, down that, on any of his land. So, and he owns that whole pasture right beside it that hooks to the pasture that the right of way comes across. That's why I can't believe that whole road passed.
Yeah, that's just not kind of, that's, I agree, it's not right.
It just seems something out of
I mean, you got to take egress and egress, but it ought to be limited.
Should be limited to just the right way, but I guess according to statute, that's not the way it is. So,
once they got off that bridge, how would they get out there to the pipeline?
Drive right through Logan's front yard.
There's a gate back there that goes back up in there. That used to be if but the creek ever really came up, that's how they used to get out.
According to what I've been told, they've got a whole list of legals on this contract. Outside of the legal that the pipeline comes across, and they can drive anywhere on any of that property that's listed on that contract. Or make a road or anything.
Are the people notified that are on the list?
It's like if they come across your pasture, they might attach some other quarter that you own. So, you know, it's a strange deal.
I'm not the one
that decides. If they're paying for it and paying damages, I guess. I mean, I can see both sides of it, but to me, it's kind of a rock and hard spot. I mean, it's kind of a difficult situation.
But we're getting rid of the roads. I might talk to them about maybe leasing a room if ours goes down, or if we think it will help. And they said it's a priority. Probably takes a couple of weeks. I don't think you guys have issues with that. If we think we want to, it's not something we normally do. That's why I'm asking. I don't really know. My broom's getting old. And that thing is not running nice stuff. Have you ever seen one of these? You know, sometimes it would.
I stay away from brooms.
Charlie Brown and Big Pen, you know how Big Pen comes down the road? Yeah. That's what this thing looks like. Yeah, it's.
Put some fenders on it.
Put some fenders on it. You get it burned off so we don't have all the people calling.
Well, that's where I was when she called. I was clear up in the east end of Quivira.
Oh, yeah.
And they pretty much got it whipped off. I mean, there's a couple of rods. We wanted to make sure we didn't swept off the road. Usually it's the edges that we have a problem with, the fine stuff. If we don't get a swept real good, it doesn't stick as well. It doesn't last as long. So.
Very good.
Okay. Anything else?
That's all I
have. Like I said, I apologize. I screwed up.
Just right to check.
Well, that thing would bounce.
Yeah. Anything else?